because everything to do with the works was embedded in Deeside people, wasn't it?
I would think so, yes, because the majority of people who lived in Shotton worked over there.
One of the things I've been asking all I call them the men of steel, if you like. What was in your snapping tin? What was in yours?
Well, I'll tell you now, and I've never let it since. I used to have boiled ham, right, on a sandwich, and by the time you come to heat it, it was that hot there that butter had melted into the ham, and you'd be trying to eat it, and your fingers were black, and there was a graphite dust in the air everywhere. And you were beating, and where it was black, you'd throw it away. But the butter had melted into the boiled ham, and it was terrible. It was terrible, you know. So I vowed I would never eat boiled ham sandwiches again. And I never have.
And did you swap sandwiches with your mates, or you?
Well, I can tell you a funny story if you wanted to hear it. I was a junior hand on a furnace on nights. We used to have to work six shifts of nights then, continuous, you know. And the first hand, he was from Park Avenue, Park Grove in Shotton, opposite Shotton Church. His name was Harry Brayton. I don't know if you know the name. And he used to fetch in some lemon drizzle cake that his wife made in a tin on nights, you know. And he'd be getting that down him. And one night, one of the lads on the furnace said, Harry, he said, have you ever thought of sharing that cake with the lads on the furnace? I'll tell you what I'll do. He said, I'll ask my wife to make another one for you and I'll fetch it in tomorrow night. And he did, I think it was about the second shift of nights. And he sliced it up and he gave us a piece each. And these lads were getting it out. I took one bite of it and the seed and all that. So, oh, God, it's terrible, that. I didn't want to upset him, so we used to have to wear aprons. I'll show you after what they were, you know, to keep the heat off your legs. So I put the cake in the apron and I go outside, that back road where the scrap was, I get the cake and I fling it. Couldn't eat it. And the other lads enjoyed it, you know. So the next night, lemon seed cake again, piece each. I thought, oh, I'd take one bite. Oh, same thing again. Throwing it on the back. By the time the last shift came, the sixth night, Harry came in with his apron like this, with all the seed cake in it, right? And he said, right, he said, I found my wife's seed cake on the back road, he said. He said, I know who's been doing it, he said. I thought, oh, gosh, you know, I was only a young lad then. I thought, oh, here we go. He said, it's you, Jack, and you, Bill, isn't it? He said, in future, he said, Leslie's having the lot. And he put it in front of me. I, oh, God, I couldn't believe it. So that was one of the funny incidents, you know, things. So, yeah, there's things like that went on all the time.